Hey guys, it's Xavier Kelly, and in today's video, I'm going to walk you through how to create a successful ad campaign. This is going to be the basic version for really just for beginners who's getting started. I'm going to do a later advanced one later on, but for this part here, it's just going to be for people who are just getting started of using Outbrain. In the last video, I went over how the dashboard works and the overview everything on that part and different things I like about Outbrain. So this is gonna go over that. So let's go straight into it. So once you log in or you sign up, depending on what you've done so far, you wanna head over to here, to your dashboard. You first log in, make sure you log into your Amplify account. Go to Ad Campaign. Never heard you wanna set your campaign name. So for this tutorial right here, we're gonna just be advertising this video right here. If this is our piece of content right here for now. This video is about how to create overlays in Photoshop. So first thing I want to do is that I would do video editing outline. Video editors. Editor video. Video tutorial. We'll do that. That's kind of what we do right now, and then I like to set a schedule. Some people run it continuously. I like to set a schedule because I think it kind of goes back to first, so you can make sure you don't spend too much money. So let's do from basically today's Wednesday, it'll take up a day or so to get what you call. So let's go Tuesday, and then air time, that's fine right there. Yep, so I would set mine at like kind of where people actually are. So I guess people be searching around, let's say 10. Okay, let's go from there to say 10 a.m., which should make it. Since I'm in Central to us, New York time, Eastern time, so 10 Eastern time is when people might start searching for. Let me actually bring it down to 9 o'clock right there. So we have that together. And that kind of, I will always set it as some type of set day so you can have and you can know so it's not running continuously and you can make sure it's not wasting money. One thing about cost per click right here is that you want to, basically as I'm clicking these right here, for you can see, you want to make sure that you're not paying too much. 84 cents, I think, is actually a lot. That's kind of what they want you to pay. Let's go to 10. As you should say, the suggested bid range to be here, but what I've learned, they will still run your ad. So this is right here is 10 cents. So they're not gonna be able to run for like, if you try to do something like one, you'll throw an error in there because the minimum is 3. And you'll get, so that's not gonna work. So I like to go around 10% if you're trying to do like somewhere like the USA. Then your daily budget. So for testing purposes, I will go through and set a daily budget of around $20. It is the minimum. I wouldn't do much higher than that portion right there because you never really know what you what's gonna be the ideal for that portion. First we gotta move this back. Oop, too much. Okay, let's change this back to the amount, 220, and we have that portion right there. You can check and see how you want it priced out if you want to accelerate it as well, just the pacing on that part. And we want to maximize clicks later on with the conversions that we have our when I set up the conversion for this campaign. And right now it's going to kind of tell you the potential broadness of this. So it has all our information right here. So since we're advertising this right here, and let's say we want to get people to subscribe to our channel, or to we won't get people to our team, or people have a course inside of this that we are kind of using that intro content. Well, we're going to go through, pick our areas. So we do like United States. And now I'll bring it down a little bit. I really recommend running separate campaigns for each areas that you're going to do. This makes it a lot more easier, especially if you have time zones right here. So maybe you can group together a couple different areas together, like Canada and United States, because those are close to each other. And then from here, it goes into your interests. So we want to do people who are, So this is all the different interests you have right here that you can do. So you can do technology interests, and you can do all the things that go along with this. Travel. It's, as you see, there's a lot of stuff to really to do in this portion. So like if you were doing something along the lines of entertainment, you can choose one of these. If you're doing something along the electronics, you can choose one of these. If you're doing home entertainment system, like if you were trying to market something on the lines of doing something along the lines, like if you created a new device, this would be a good way to kind of help push it out to as well to get awareness. And I really would use Outbrain for awareness campaigns. Right now, I do believe there are better methods than actually going out and trying to do converting on here. I do think if you use this as the first part of your funnel to get people introduced to your topic, and then keep funnel them down from emails or from other markets by having your pixels on there, it works pretty well. So let's say we do this part here. Let's say we do technology. What stuff don't we want on here? So let's say we don't want this. People probably not searching for that. People might not search for cloud computing, not virtual reality, not search for science. These people will be searching for software, they might be searching social media a little bit, but however, probably not mobile, and we can go through that part. The next thing, we can go to platforms. So if we're trying to subscribe, we can do it with your phones, depending on how we have everything set up for the phone. I think for the most part, I like the desktops. And I will kind of separate these to kind of check. And then you add this in there. And then you have your desktops right here for that section. Just remove smartphones, just leave desktops. And then you just say the operating system. Say if you figured out that majority of people on Mac are more likely to subscribe because they'd be more likely to be. Let's say they are more likely to be designers. We have that portion. So we narrow down by there. We narrow down by the interest that we have set right here. And then we can narrow down as well. Down until actually going through and really just going through and trying to make sure that our targeting are set correctly and that we're doing the right thing. So we can do that. So we want to exclude ad block users, most likely. Just going to leave them out of the way. Use this thin network. This is kind of iffy. I see something to test, but yeah, it's something to go through. Add in some tracking portion, basically your suffix style tracking code, like Google Analytics, that keep everything tracking. You can add other pixels in as well. You can add it right there. This makes it really interesting. Next, we go to our content. This right here is where we can use a URL or RSS feed. And basically RSS feed would be basically a feed like to your blog or to other content you have right there. So every time a new one pops up, it basically pulls information and then creates a new ad for you. So this is really good if you're advertising your blog on a regular basis. You can import different ones too as well. So for us, go here, copy the link. So we need to enter a title a little bit. So for us, we will say something on the lines of, let's go with something on the lines of, you know, one skill to learn to separate. Let's say we go one skill that will increase the quality of your designs. And I just realized I was talking about video editing. I don't know where I got that from. But yeah, to that part. And just all market terms, I'll capitalize the first letter of each word. Anything underneath like two kind of letters, sometimes I won't do it, but you can do it. I do it most times in AdWords, and we have that. And then we go through here. Yep, we have that. We'll keep it that way right there. And then I'll go through here and I'll actually go and actually maybe do something different right here. put in things. So basically I will create a template. So if you're doing something in Canva, if you're doing your going through and actually creating your ad and you need some custom artwork, instead of going out and buying some things or trying to have somebody build it, you can do it yourself. Go to Canva, basically sign up, and then go to custom dimensions, go to 1200, and then for your width 800 for everything, for that, for your height. This be like your custom L right here. I really recommend using images with people in them. It work a lot better. So that's just reminders, just from testing that I've done. You can come down here to elements, you go to photos. They have tons of photos out here right now, and then you can literally go through and pick something that might be cool. Just for us, we'll put a what you call it to it. Oh, we want that one. Just get something, put a person in it working at a computer. Oh, right here. Perfect. This is kind of exactly what we want right here. Some people add text to it. I think that it kind of can go work both ways depending on how you want to do it. So let's go ahead and download this as a JPEG. Okay, let that download. Oh, and as you sign up for stuff, you don't have to sign up. Come back over here, and we can drag in this image. So we said increase your photo designs. Yep. So we have that, and that'll be everything we basically push out. And then we'll push submit. And then basically we have our campaign right there. We would go back through and not call it video editors. Obviously made a mistake on that part. I don't know what I was thinking on that part. So let's go back. We'll go back and actually change that portion. So this is going to be for photo editors. And so one way that really can go about actually improving this and actually making this seem something that actually can generate more money. So if you have a course about doing photo edits or doing graphic design work at all, basically what you do, if you create a video, maybe that video is part of the first three parts that takes them to a playlist of the first three or four videos of that course, then they can walk through and learn, and at the end you can sell them on it. This is a good way to get people introduced to your content. And one thing I realized too as well, using your actual headlines on here, using your headlines and using your text really allows you to be able to push and don't allow certain people to be able to be able to click. And not so much don't allow because they don't show up for it. It's just that you need to make your heading, make your headline, and then also make your image targeted enough where only person who will click that will be someone who's in your audience. And then go back through and use your publisher guides to get that, basically exclude other people and boost up your click rate for only to show on the appropriate sites that have the people on there. Eventually, Outbrain will, I think in the future, allow you to be able to choose categories for those people in certain areas to be able to push across different blogs right now, but currently I don't. I understand why they don't too as well, because it'd be hard for them to be able to generate sales for all the different sites and have people on it. But it still works out in that part here. But for the most part, guys, you know, that's basically how you set up a campaign. It's pretty simple. You can pause it, everything, then change everything up. As you see, it's under review, and basically it takes like a couple days sometimes. But as you get in the grind, it actually goes a lot faster. So guys, if you haven't already, make sure you head over to my YouTube channel, subscribe there. So right now you're probably on YouTube anyway, so subscribe on there. And then I really appreciate you guys for actually taking time to watch this video. One thing I'm trying to do more with the channel is go through and kind of walk you through the whole process of actually developing, actually building and getting a product. And this doesn't have to be a software product, but anything you want to be, from an ebook to a regular book or to a software product. So one thing I'm trying to do is help you decide on who your audience is, and then to go from there, build an audience, and then once you have an audience, to build a product for that audience that you can sell to them, and then at the last help you sell those products. So make sure you stay tuned to learn more about it. We're going to cover more stuff basically a couple times a week. Bumping up the channel, I'm doing a lot more redoing my website, because as you see, I've seen, I did this so long ago, it's about like 3 years or so, and it looks terrible. So if you're doing a website and you have all the new courses and everything on it too as well, so you can check those out. Just want to say, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.